गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द चैप्टर नंबर 10th, इंडिया विंस फ्रीडम. इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन हाउ आर लीडर्स फॉर्म्ड इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस. सो नाउ लेट्स मूव फॉरवर्ड. लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द मुस्लिम लीग. As we have seen in the previous video that the Britishers were trying to instigate Muslims against Hindu. Finally, they got success and a new league came into existence in 1906. That was the Muslim League. The Muslims became the puppet of Britishers who reserved separate seats for the Muslims in election. And it was indeed a serious blow to the freedom of struggle of India. Period of repression. Khilafat movement. In 1960, the Ottoman Turkey was defeated by the British and harsh treaty was going to be imposed on Ottoman Emperor, who was known as the Khalifa. To defend the Khalifa power, a committee was formed as Khilafat Committee, and that movement was called as Khilafat movement. That movement was led by three Maulanas, Shaukat Ali, Muhammad Ali and Abdul Kalam Azad. Finally, Congress leader and these leader came close to each other and Congress started home rule movement. But as Britishers had been at war with Germany since 1914, so they passed very strict laws in 1990 to repress these two movement. The British passed the Rowlatt Act against those two movements. According to this act, the government got the power to arrest anybody without any inquiry or trial. But Mahatma Gandhi ji decided to fight against the Rowlatt Act. He chose the weapon of Satyagraha or non-violence for the fight. Have a look at this picture, how quietly they are defending. This movement was known as Satyagraha. The Jallianwala Bagh Massacre. The British ruler got very angry. On 13th April 1919, the infamous Jallianwala Bagh incident took place. On that day, crowd of villagers who had come to Amritsar to attend fair gathered in Jallianwala Bagh. Being from outside the city, they were not aware of the law that had been imposed. That was martial law. General Dyer entered the area and blocked all the exit points and open fired the crowd, killing thousands. People jumped in well to save themselves. All this anger exploded into the nationwide movement in 1920. Non-cooperation movement. Mahatma Gandhi declared that British rule was established in India with the cooperation of Indians, and it survived only because of this cooperation. If Indians refused to cooperate, British rule in India would collapse within a year and Swaraj will come. So what Indians did? They started boycotting the things. They started boycotting civil services, army, police, courts, etc. Then a group of young men, Bhagat Singh, Sukhdev and Rajguru, they threw a bomb in the assembly hall in Delhi. But what Britishers did? They were arrested, tried and hanged. Salt Satyagraha. Gandhi ji broke the Salt Act and started civil disobedience movement. What was Salt Satyagraha? Mahatma Gandhi ji found in salt a powerful symbol that could unite the nation. So Mahatma Gandhi ji started his famous Salt March, accompanied by 78 of his trusted volunteers. This marked the beginning of the civil disobedience movement. Demand for Pakistan. After the Turkey war, British again started instigating the Muslims. Now, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, their leader, Muslim leader, demanded for separate land for Muslim. Finally, home rule was granted to Indians through an act. Elections were held and Congress won the election. But soon, Second World War started. And British declared India would join the Second World War, but Congress leader were not ready for it. Quit India Movement. The Congress started the Quit India Movement in 1942. Mr. Jinnah, the leader of the Muslims, came out with an open demand for Pakistan now. The British rulers declared Indian National Congress as illegal party and banned it and arrested its leaders. Subhash Chandra Bose escaped to Germany and then to Japan. He formed an Azad Hind Fauj or Indian National Army. He attacked British rule to quit India and advanced up to Manipur, but suddenly he died in an air crash. India wins freedom. World War II had ended. In 1945, Labour Party came up to power there with Lord Attlee as the new Prime Minister. Lord Attlee decided to set India free. He sent Lord Mountain as the new Governor General of India with a view to transferring power to Indian leaders. But the Muslim League didn't give up their demand for Pakistan. And then India was divided into two parts, India and Pakistan, at the midnight of 14th August 1947. Lord Mountain was made the first Governor General of Free India. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru became the first Prime Minister of India, and Mr. C. Rajgopalachari became the Governor General of India in 1948. Finally, we got freedom. The story of our freedom struggle is inspiring. It was struggle against injustice. It was a struggle for liberation from imperialism as well, equal right for all. We salute our freedom fighters who gave their lives to make it possible for us to breathe in free India. Now it's our duty to work hard, honestly, to fulfill the dreams of our great leaders, to glorify India and making her a golden sparrow again. So students, that's how we got freedom, and that was the end of our chapter. Thank you.